Zulu lions taught to seek dangers. Raven defiance, boy, the Lord was doing favors. Blaze through the fire, yeah, we had a few. Lost a few wages. Still coming rampant, misbehaving, misbehaving. Flavors. Still coming anti up, rebelling with my ravers. Still don't give a f- about who be the latest. Can't be locked up in them cages. Start living up to what the f- you think of days.
But hey, what about it?
So I stepped on stage, they were like, see the crowd going in, they were like.
With the skyline of Manhattan as our backdrop, we are across the East River in the fabled borough of Brooklyn, New York. Tonight, hard to believe, our final Thursday night game of the year, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Shamrocks of Brooklyn. Here's the kicker, Jason Myers, to get this one started, and we are underway from Brooklyn. Here comes Marquez Stevenson now from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Sanders to begin the drive. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Down. From the 33, here's second and a yard. A play fake. Now Young. Forced out to his... And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And while all of that was going on with a sack, it appears, unfortunately, we have an injured player. Always unfortunate to see an injury, especially this close to the end of the regular season. We'll step aside. So now an early 3rd and 10 here on their opening drive. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The third down conversion is successful. Give him 12 yards that time.
So that's what that elbow in my ribs was all about. You thought they were going to throw the ball as well.
Absolutely. I think everybody thought they were throwing the football. Caught him off guard.
Yeah, I'm telling you, when you have the courage to make that type of a play call, a lot of times you actually get rewarded.
Gets it quickly out to Marshall. Into space at the 45. And finally brought down right at the midfield stripe. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. That was a lightning-fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately. So he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
Ready.
On play action, Young. And that's complete to Sanders. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook. Take out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for? It's who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night. Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Here comes the 7th play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's 3rd down. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Another run here with Sanders. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. When we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's second down at 7.
Go ultra.
They run with Sanders off the option. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. The Young keeps it moving right. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
They'll come up facing 3rd and 5.
Wait. Ready?
Now Young. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And now off to the races, down the right side.
And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
They'll run with Walker to begin the drive. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
From the lineman to the guy running with it, that was a well-executed first down by the offense. With 2 shots left to get the first, you can get a little aggressive here on second down if you want and try for some bigger yardage.
Here now, 2nd and 4. Sticking with Walker on second down.
And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be 3rd down.
But you look at this defense.
This unit, they've struggled a little bit against the pass, ranked number 21 in the league.
And I think you're going to see some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency, maybe even both. They definitely need some help in the secondary.
Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part to get out of the football, but you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum of the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, 3 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Remember last time out, they threw the interception on their first drive. Good news, their defense backed him up, so it's still 0-0 here as they begin their second possession.
Yeah, and one great way to judge a defense, how do they handle what we call sudden change when all of a sudden, you know, it goes against their offense and they have to run out in the field and try and put out the fire? Give this one great kudos for getting out there and not letting that interception lead to points. Excellent job by them defensively.
And he's brought down. So the ball moves from their own 41 to the other 41 here for 1st and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. 59 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start. From the 35, back to work on 2nd and 4. Now Young. That swung out wide to Sanders. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 17-yard line. That one good for a 1st down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
Ready?
From the red zone now, Young. Touchdown! Christian Kirk, his 5th touchdown now on the year.
And the Shamrocks will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Pinheiro's extra point up and good.
And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they are losers of two straight coming into this Thursday night game. Is it more difficult, CD, when you take a losing streak into a quick turnaround game like this?
It certainly is, because you don't get time to work on the issues that you've had throughout the season that have caused you to have the record that you're having. You can't really get those set. So now you're trying to minimize those and maximize what you've been doing well. And I remember a game recently where one of the assistant coaches said to the head coach, forget our running back rotation. This guy has a hot hand, and they rode him to a victory. Those are things you have to...
Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
And not all spectacular catches are the result of a pass that maybe was not thrown quite right. Sometimes it's thrown in the perfect spot, and you have to just go get it. And he did that right there.
No fear there in the middle of the field. Taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. From the 34-yard line here, second and three. Now back to throw. Left side, he finds Smith and Jigba. First time that they called his number tonight, and it gets him a first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
A couple of first downs have him to the 40 now on first and 10. On play action, they'll throw. In trouble, and he's taken down. It looks like a 12-yard loss there on the first down sack.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Looking to throw. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end.
Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And he is caught. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Can't get away, and he's taken down. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on second and 15. He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's going the other way. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't he?
He really does, and I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame, and anytime he didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him this is what that time is, just what you're talking about, training him to understand this is the knowledge you have, make sure the ball's gone. Didn't happen in this case.
66 yards for him on the ground so far tonight, as he has been terrific in his first half from the 31. Here's second and three. Here is Young. side by Kirk. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver trying to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Miles Sanders, his 12th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Shamrocks have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And it's now 14-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
Here's 2nd and 10. Back to throw here. And he's taken in by the tight end Fan. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A gain there of 21 yards. They'll look to throw here on first down. Throw out wide to Walker. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
A throw over the middle, taken in. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 at a first down. Up the middle they run. It's Walker. And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 2nd and 5. They're going to look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Amari Barno. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, they could really put him in command. He's got a man complete. Through the middle of the field. And all the way in for the touchdown. Terrace Marshall, 74 yards. And the Shamrocks are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And it's now 21-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the... And all deep in his own territory. Coughs up the football. Oh, and one of the linebackers has got it. So a teammate picking him up there. That was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy.
because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
A tough adjustment to the NFL throughout his rookie season, and his problem with turnovers is only exacerbated by his early showing today. That's a couple for him here in this first half, and he's cleared the double-digit mark for the entire season.
Here we go, here we go.
Following the interception, Young. Flush to his right. That one complete downfield to Kirk. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They'll run with Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Miles Sanders with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Shamrocks are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes the score 28-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with the score where it is, even though I think they'd love to get back to the locker room, they may be forced to try and get something out of this drive. And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. Brian Burns, the one to bring him down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And this sequence won't do any favors to his rushing totals as they get him behind the line again. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage. And now third and 11 coming up. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. They'll elect to bring it out here. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And he will bring this down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. So they take the deficit into the lockers. You know they had plans to receive the football. A nice drive, instead a fumble on the kickoff.
And that can be demoralizing right there because, as you pointed out, they had designs on coming out and, okay, we're going to change things here in the second half. Instead, with a deficit already, they cough it up, and now they've got to find a way to keep the score from mounting bigger against them.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Once again with Sanders, and he will take this one in for a touchdown. Miles Sanders, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Shamrocks have taken a 5-touchdown lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes this 35-0 now. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone.
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
Well, it's not the first time we've seen him give one up here during his rookie season. And in this case, zone coverage forced the mistake. He's made some strides week to week in how he's handling the different type of coverages that he's seeing. But clearly, there's some growing still to do.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Young. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
They go play action. Young. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. He's up now to 80 yards receiving in the ball game, and he's got a first down. First and 10 at the 26-yard line. Throwing, Young. That would almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. 106 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Ready?
On third down, they'll run with Sanders. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
Nice job there finding room to maneuver, and he worked his way into another first down. And look, they had great field position to start, but boy, they've done a nice job taking advantage of it.
Now they're just hoping to cap it off. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. Ball on the 8. It's 2nd and 4. They'll go again with Sanders. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is 3rd down and 8.
A give up the middle, Hubbard. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Chuba Hubbard, a 12-yard touchdown run. And the Shamrocks have taken a 6-touchdown lead. Pinheiro now to add the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. A turnover on the last drive. They had the issue in the first half as well. And that's really, unfortunately for them, helped to put this game out of reach.
And you know they won't want to admit it to themselves. But we know that winning the game is pretty much out of the picture now. So their bottom line is, how do they play a clean game the rest of this one, right? Take care of the football, no more turnovers, and see how that works.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. He'll look to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. A gain of 8 there on the play, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. They'll try for the first with Walker, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. By the skin of their teeth, they are able to convert on third and inches. Back to throw. He completes this to Walker. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. They'll look to throw here. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Xavier Woods with a pick. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
And he's up across midfield and down into Seattle territory. 120 yards rushing for him now as his big night continues.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Second down, back to Sanders. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Check White.
On third down, they turn to Sanders. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage. But you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway.
Well, the disparity in this game, it just seems to grow with each possession here, Charles. They are really struggling. They have not put up a single point, and on the up.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. It's a big play there for Seattle. 42 yards.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. It's second down.
This defense just continues to bottle up that ground game. And look, I mean, the deficit right now for this offense is so big that it might not matter. But you're still in the third quarter. They're probably going to have to try things through the air, Charles.
I agree with you totally. That's what they'll have to do. They do need to run it occasionally to take a few hits off the quarterback, because right now, you just know those pass rushers are fired up to get after it.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Walker now on first and 10. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Sticking with Walker on second down. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points.
Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
Myers' kick is good. And they'll get back three, but this remains a large deficit. Well, it's a Pyrrhic victory at best, but Charles, no team wants to get shut out, so it's hard to blame them for taking the three there.
You can't blame them one bit. It hasn't been the best performance, that's for darn sure. But there is something to be said for fighting to avoid the goose egg, and they're at least trying to finish out strong.
And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is something that you and I
enjoy.
We enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it number one for what we've seen this season.
An option handoff given to Sanders. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. And quickly, they get to the line. On second down, Young. Open man is Kirk, complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again, as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 31-yard line. He's now just 3 yards shy of 197 yards receiving on the contest, and a first down. The middle they go with Sanders. Stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. Now second and five. Another run with Sanders. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26.
That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
Tough spot looking at second and 16 here after the big loss. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Miles Sanders, 26 yards. And the Shamrocks look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Nice job by the defense figuring that play out and holding it to a short game. But I don't think the offense is going to be daunted. They actually accomplished their goal there. Now they've got them aware that they can throw a screen at them, maybe to slow the pass rush down a little bit, and they can throw it downfield.
The second down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A well-executed 22-yard gain. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long. Had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. And Walker with it over the middle. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. They'll go with a touch pass here, trying to pick it up. Fights loose. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play.
But not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him, and we'll step aside for a moment.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one at the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. Jason Myers now for the extra point. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
Stevenson now, he's going to bring this out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Ready up.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Here we go.
The ball resting on the 20. Here's second and six. Here's Sanders. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. Able to power through. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. Well, partner, under the lights in primetime, this offense, they gave the nation quite a show, putting up that many points to come away with what will certainly be a memorable win for them.
And, Brandon, I think it's as simple as this. Some players, some teams, they're just meant for the big stage. And when they get a chance to play in this type of atmosphere where all eyes are on them and all the lights are shining brightly, they show up and they show out.
So for Brooklyn, they moved in.
wrist. That's a freezer. Give me assist. Give me teamwork. Keep it consistent. For the distance.
Hey, used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pumps. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean apprentice, I'm a diamond and the running back. Used to have a silver tooth but I was just a pup. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pump. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean apprentice, I'm a diamond and the rough. First order of biz, no snitch. And I try to keep it silent but the kids don't